is that dry fasting speeds up skin repair. So there's two things we know about this study. One is that it slows down premature aging of skin, and if you have any kind of wound that you need to heal, dry fasting has proven to be really helpful for repairing wounds. Okay, Dr. Mindy here, and on this video, we're gonna talk about dry fasting. I'm a little nervous to teach you guys this because dry fasting is no food, no water. There's a tremendous benefit to it, and also you need to be very safe. So listen all the way through to this video because I'm gonna give you some guidelines. And if you're new to my channel, let me just say welcome. I am a woman on a mission. I wanna get 1 million people fasting this year. So hit the subscribe button and the notification bell. And those of you that share my video out, just you guys know how much I love being on this journey with you. And don't forget, it's fast training week. So Element, if you wanna win a free box of Element minerals, go to the companion guide. Just put companion guide in your notes and there's a link there on how you can win a free box. They sponsor our fast training week. And again, if you're new to my channel, every fast training week, we have a companion guide that goes with it. It's free, so you can succeed at that. Just put companion guide in your notes. Okay, dry fasting. Whew, I'm a little nervous to teach you all this one, but I trust you are gonna follow some good guidelines here. Now, there are 5 reasons you would want to dry fast. I'll talk about what dry fasting is here in a moment. And then I wanna finish this video up with, it is fast training week. And if you're new to my channel, at once a month, 5-day period, once a month, we fast together. We practice news fasts, and this one is dry fasting. So I will give you the rules to fast training week at the end of the video. So here's what dry fasting is. It's exactly what it sounds like. It is no food and no water. So you guys that are like, what about my coffee? That has water in it. So no food, no water. And here's the other thing I want you to know about dry fasting. And I will say this on every video this week. The research has shown that dry fasting from 12 to 24 hours for the healthy person is safe. Over 24 hours, I do not advocate or stand for over 24 hours. So a lot of you guys ask us questions, can I dry fast more than 24? And the answer is no, we do not recommend that. And if you have a serious medical condition, I don't want you jumping into this dry fast, even the short dry fast, without the support of your medical doctor, okay? So here's what dry fasting is. No food, no water, talked about that. Why would we do that? And here's what's really cool and why I wanted to pick dry fasting for fast training week is we have incredible research done on people who practice Ramadan. And those of you that practice Ramadan, you know what I'm talking about, but from sun up to sundown, no food, no water. It's a religious practice that has been done safely for years and years. Now, from a fasting perspective, what's really cool is that we have a lot of research on dry fasting, and much of it that I'm gonna bring you is actually dry fasting that way over a 30-day period. So I will make sure that I emphasize some of these results you're gonna hear me talk about have to be done over a 30-day period. So here are the 5 reasons that you would want to dry fast. The first is you can burn more fat. Now, there's an incredible study that was done on over 240 people showing that after 20 days of this circadian dry fasting done through Ramadan, that every single person in the study, every single one of them lost weight. The video after this, I'm going to break that study down for those of you that are interested. But for some of you that are approaching fasting, building yourself a fasting lifestyle, dry fasting could be something really interesting to throw in so that you can lose more weight and burn more fat. Okay, second thing that we see in research is that dry fasting resets your immune system. Now, this one was done only on 10 people for 5 days. I do not advocate a 5-day dry fast. I will link the study down there for those of you that want to see it. But here's what they found is that short-term dry fasting will improve antioxidants. It's anti-ischemic, so it'll improve blood flow. It's immune stimulating. It helps with swelling and inflammation. And these were all done on, again, 10 people over 5-day period of dry fasting. I'll leave that study below. Number three, the third reason you would want to dry fast is it reduces inflammation. Now, this one was done again on Ramadan fasting. It was done on 50 healthy adults. And what they found by the third week of the dry Ramadan style dry fasting, that the cytokine inflammation was at its lowest. So this is great. What do we know about cytokines? What have we been hearing about cytokines and cytokine storms? So really interesting that cytokine has been that word that's emerged in 2020 and 2021, and it goes way beyond catching a virus. There are cytokine storms going on in your body that are creating a chronic inflammatory response that's leading to things like joint pain and, you know, general malaise, problems sleeping, brain fog. And what we see here, 50 healthy adults that during Ramadan on the 3 weeks of this circadian dry fasting, what we're noticing is that cytokine storm come down. That's pretty cool. I'll link that study as well. Number four, and I have a whole video coming to you guys on number four because I'm fascinated on this one, is that dry fasting speeds up skin repair. So there's two things we know about this study. One is that it slows down premature aging of skin, and if you have any kind of wound that you need to heal, dry fasting has proven to be really helpful for repairing wounds. So this is pretty cool, and that's why I'm gonna do a whole separate video on it. But whoever would think about dry fasting for skin repair, we tend to think of skin as needing hydration, but there's a reason why, so I will bring that to you. And then the last one, and probably my personal favorite with dry fasting, is the amount of BDNF you're gonna get when you dry fast. BDNF is like fertilizer for your brain. So what we're finding is that dry fasting will improve brain clarity. It will help repair injured neurons. It's a great tool for powering your brain up. So five really interesting ways we can use dry fasting and cycle it in. What we're gonna do for Fast Training Week that I think will be really exciting, you guys let me know what you think, is that our goal for everybody is to go 12 hours without food or water. And I'm going to give you two options on how you can do this. You can mimic Ramadan style fasting where you get up before the sun rises. If you want your coffee, if you want water, you could have it, but you're gonna have it before the sun gets up. Now, when the sun rises, you're gonna go 12 hours from the time that you drank that water, you drank your cup of coffee, and you're going to, after 12 hours, you can break your fast and have a ketobiotic meal. What's ketobiotic? We've talked about this. It is 50 grams of protein, 50 grams of net carbs, and then over 60% of your food coming from fat. But it has to be after 12 hours of dry fasting. So that is option number one. Now, option number two is you could skip that morning water and coffee and just go anywhere from 12 to 24 hours of dry fasting. So that would mean your bedtime as well. So you would go to sleep, wake up, no food, no water, make sure you've gone at least 12 hours without, which for a lot of you guys should be pretty easy. You may even stretch it more to 24 hours. And then when you break your fast, you break it with ketobiotic. So I hope you understand this. Again, two options. As always, be really safe. And then know that we have the companion guide. So if you want the companion guide, just put companion guide in the notes and I will send you a link so that you can get all the rules of this fast training week in that companion guide. But that's dry fasting, really cool over the next 5 days. I'm gonna bring you a lot of cool research on it. I think it's a great variation to work into your fasting lifestyle. I don't think we should do it for long periods of time, but I think it's a really helpful one for those five things I just talked about. So if you've dry fasted with great success, put it in the comments so everybody can learn from it. And as always, I hope that helps.